Okay guys, I'm out in Florida. I had to stop by and check out Ty's place. Ty's got an incredible collection of really, really cool iguanas and all kinds of, if it's got four legs and it's called a reptile, it's like Ty's place, right?
Yeah, there's you not got much it, you don't have. So I'm just gonna say yes, yes, yes. That's
listen,
it,
yes,
okay?
Yes,
you
yes.
Talk.
So the cool part is he's actually gonna throw an event on May 20th, and it's to actually raise money for iguanas, for basically what organization?
Conservation. We're gonna probably give money to people doing research, maybe field research.
Field research. And different stuff like that for iguanas, because you know what? The cool part is Ty always makes sure to help out where his heart is, and he loves animals and really enjoys them, and he's always been a big contributor. And couldn't, anyway, besides all those formalities, when you see some of the animals you have, you'll understand the passion that drives them. So we're gonna have a good day today. Stay tuned. So this is one of Ty's Lewis Eye crosses, and it's absolutely beautiful. Look how gorgeous. I can't imagine what he looks like. We had to come early because we have other things to do today, but you know what? We didn't come that too early because he's out and starting to color up. Look at his eye color. It is blue tint on that black. Now he's dark because it's morning. He's gonna be a little bit darker. The warmer a reptile gets, typically the lighter they get in most cases, just because this darkness is for obvious reason. If you put a black shirt on and it's a sunny morning, guess what you're gonna be? Warm. And that's exactly what he's out. So he's out basking when it's the winter time, and he's absolutely gorgeous. Or well, I mean, gee whiz. Ty says he's 20 and he's been your buddy. How many years have you had it, Ty?
I had him for about 6 years.
Six years. Yep. He is absolutely gorgeous.
His name is Cooper.
Cooper. Hey, yeah. Not a mini Cooper, that's for sure. Anyway, we're gonna set him down and we're gonna go look around. So you know you're making a dent on the population on Earth of cool animals when you. This is your incubator. You basically heat the entire room and fill it up with eggs.
$10,000
animal. I totally understand. Yeah.
But this is how
I haven't even seen an albino in the U.S.
These are albino.
Right. That's
you can
awesome.
Pull them out and do whatever you want.
Okay.
And there's some albinos here. We just shipped these guys up to actually Aizu in Japan.
Oh.
We just sold the Nigulotia, three of them. You know, then I have real rare ones like this, Octotalus.
I haven't had one of those in my hands for years.
I think they're just really cool.
Wow.
They've been.
Maybe I haven't even had, this isn't a Western, is it?
This is a Western.
Okay.
Yeah. Hospitalis Western.
So yeah. I have personally not had one of these in my hands for at least 18 years. To tell you the truth, I had no options because I had to survive and feed my family. And the one I had to ship to Japan because they were paying silly money. So, there's actually gonna. I know I'm gonna see a few of them that I used to be able to have on a regular basis, but I ended up truly, honestly exporting almost all the ones that were in the United States, and this is gorgeous. I haven't seen one of these. Actually, the one I had was an adult.
Gorgeous. You know, I tell you, you mentioned Japan. I just shipped off 1.2 Nigulotia to them yesterday.
Yeah.
Playful Aizu.
I used to send the multifasciatus off.
Oh yeah.
I actually multifasciatus. You have one?
Yes. No, I don't.
Okay.
That's one.
Multifasciata are kind of a short, real heavy body, really heavy stripes right. Like that one had on its head, and they're gorgeous. They remind me of a shingleback, but they don't have the shingles on them because they got the same body type, but they got a short. Gorgeous animal. Unfortunately, the Japanese really enjoyed them and they could afford them, and so they. I bought every single one in the United States and ended up sending them over there. They put them on breeder projects and different things, and what an incredible animal. So
yeah.
We're gonna show you some really cool skinks right now. So the reason why Ty keeps these inside is because, to be honest, these are really, really rare, and so they need to be super protected. Not that the animals out there that they don't get taken care of or anything, obviously, because they have all natural everything, but these kind of just need to be supervised a little bit closer, make sure there's nothing going on, and because there's just not very many of them. Those out there are almost in a natural, I mean, they are in a natural setting in real life. They're producing their eggs, they're doing everything they need, and these ones here just don't have a big enough colony yet, working on building the colony up, because it's gonna take a while. And this is a beautiful shingleback. You can see why they call them a shingleback. And nickname is Pinecone Skink because they look like a pine cone, right? And look at this. These are absolutely gorgeous. Another species that's totally black. I mean, they're just absolutely, they look like the same thing, melanistic, but they're not. They're another species. And they're just gorgeous animals. And I, you know what? These are some animals that I absolutely gotta get for my zoo. I used to have them too, but dang, the economy gets bad and your kids get hungry, stuff happens. So, in Japan, like I said, in Japan, to be honest, they were buying everything really rare for me that was, you know, in great shape and beautiful, because they have really good taste over there. So, okay, and look at the pattern, I mean, the scalation and all that. It's just an incredible creature. I mean, unbelievable.
I've never
touched one of these in my life. This is a rare animal here. How many of these are in the United States?
I have no idea.
Yeah,
I
wouldn't be surprised if this is one of the few ones. You know, I mean, this is incredible. I'm sure it came from Europe, huh? Did it come from Europe?
Yes.
Unbelievable.
They have they have all the paper and...
They're absolutely a gorgeous animal. I mean, look at that. Just gloss, black, gorgeous. I mean, normally, of course, these have a pattern. We'll show you one. And is this a Western or what is the locale?
No, this is Eastern.
These are Eastern blue tongues. They originate in Australia. Black ones are a morph.
Yep.
Just like our retics and stuff. And that is an incredible, incredible animal right there. Oh gosh, that is wonderful. I can't wait. I'm gonna have to get in line for one of these guys as soon as they get making some more babies.
You see the red underneath?
Oh yeah, look at this even. It's got like a red belly, and it's incredibly marbled red belly. But boy, I'm telling you, that is black. So, whew, beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
I think that's about it. The rest of them are multiple.
I saw some albinos over there. Don't worry, we're on our
way. Yeah, that's right. I forgot to say the albinos.
He's sandbagging us, guys. This is an albino blue tongue. Absolutely cool. These things are incredible. I've never, ever, ever touched an albino blue tongue, and I've never touched the melanistic blue tongue. And I'll tell you, so this is amelanistic, and this is literally, it's black. It's anatheristic in its highest form. It's completely black. Look how gorgeous this is. I mean, that is incredible group of animals. And blue tongue skinks are actually not easy to breed, believe it or not, because they're a lot like the cyclura. The females will beat the females up, the females will beat the males up, the males will beat, you gotta really know what you're doing. And luckily, I mean, shoot, he's been doing it for a couple days and it's his passion. I never met anybody like that.
So I haven't either.
So he's very, very successful at it because first of all, I'm sure he has the right crew to back him, but I bet you his passion makes it all happen. You said how many cyclura you make a year roughly?
We produce almost 700 cyclura left.
700, and can you believe it, guys? He sells every one of them before I can even get one because I can't afford them.
Yeah, they become real popular over the last few years.
They are really awesome, and you know what? Hopefully soon you'll be seeing some of this action going on because I'm even going to get in line for these.
Yep.
Go find some cool new other stuff. Look at this, guys. It's happy hour. Look at this. So, just to clarify, this is rated R for reptiles. Even though these are tortoises, they still fall in the cold-blooded. And so that little boy over there is trying to make the world a better place to live.
Yeah, they're welcome.
Beautiful. These are such beautiful enclosures. I'm jealous. This is better than gardening in my home. So these are marginated tortoises, and they're actually pretty cool. When they get real big, you can see that they start to get like a duck bill thing on the back of them. They're really pretty cool. They're amazing. So these tegus here, this little breeding group, you got 1.1 or
1.2? 1.2. 1.2. Two female on each side.
So the way this is set up is he has you have two females over here,
Yeah, one female here, and then one male. Oh, okay. This is 10 by 10.
So to make it real safe for the tegus, what he does, he actually separates the males by and the females so that they, you know, feeding and different things, keep them all perfect, have them all happy. And then, of course, when it gets the right time of year, then they go ahead and let them pass right through. They have actually a tunnel system.
How many tegus you make? A lot.
Oh, I think more than 1,000 last.
More than 1,000 tegus in a year. And these things are just living the dream. I mean, how can you get better? All the food you want, got the girlfriend, got the boyfriend. Wait till you see this beauty.
Come on. There you go.
Now this is an albino tegu, and it's a T positive tegu.
Yep.
So the T positive means that it's got melanin inside the instead of being amelanistic, which is a lack of the black pigment, this still has some pigment left in the albinism. And so that makes it like a purple color. They're absolutely gorgeous. Now, this is a little female, it would look like. Mm-hmm. And it is, because the funny part is most people don't know tegus are very easy to sex. You just reach right here, and if they have a little tiny bead, it's a boy. It's like a little special scale. And if it doesn't have it, it's a girl. And they have characteristics that are like long, skinny heads, a girl. Usually the heavy heads are a boy, but that isn't always really accurate. When you get to be a great big female that's real dominant, and they can have pretty big jowls on them even. So, but this is a gorgeous little albino.
So far, it's been what, 6 years I've been doing this? I've always opened the door in like March, right?
Right.
But at this time here, I wanted to do some experiment. I just left them open. The whole hibernation and see what the fertility is better or not. And
right.
I'm doing some different experiments here.
Right.
Okay. So this three research. Pants and those three pants, I left them. Yeah.
Look at that male. He's absolutely gorgeous. He's got like a beautiful burgundy, reddish color head. And I had a Jeep color painted that color one time. Actually, it was a Land Cruiser.
Yeah, I mean, look at him. Look at the animal after not eating for 20 half months.
Yeah, that's incredible. Just perfect body weight, perfect muscle tone. You can see they're just solid. Look at the back. You can see the muscle down their back.
The
ridge from the, I mean, they're in really good shape. Absolutely beautiful.
Of course, you can see the stomach is empty, right?
You
can see the stomach, but the muscle tone is incredible.
I can see it. So this is really cool. So tegus like humidity, and of course we're in Florida, so that's not a big issue, but still, you've got to have guaranteed water, right? And this is a completely natural ground system. It's got, you know, the ground does what it's supposed to do. The tegus have everything they need, but to ensure there's no way they don't have a water issue, they have over water sprinklers. And how often do you run them, Ty?
We have them on Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, unless it's
raining. So if you're ever thirsty, you know where to come, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And of course, if you live in Florida, you know it rains like every single day, certain times of the year.
Not in the winter, Jay, not in the winter.
No, in the summer,
yeah,
every
yeah.
single day, at about 5 o'clock.
I tell you, with the passion, I'm like our old style, right?
Right.
I like things easy.
Right.
Okay.
Of course.
Yeah. So I tend to find a place like this.
Right.
And have animals I could keep easily.
Right.
I don't want to fight them.
Yeah. And that's exactly right. That's why the funny part is that's why I don't breed Burmese pythons.
Exactly.
Because when I breed Burmese pythons, the animals, just to be honest, they didn't do good in groups. It was a lot harder to breed them, even though they're easier to breed in an environment with more of them. It is just, they've got health issues when you get too many in one location. If you have a couple pets, it's really, they're great pets. I'm not knocking them, but it's really funny how certain species just love to be in groups, love to, you know, they do well, their health is great, they respond well as pets. They're like everything that you enjoy, and you can enjoy them, and they can enjoy you. And so it's really like, just like the, what was your rhino over there's name?
No, that was not rhino,
I'm
buddy. That was Lewis I hybrid.
Lewis I hybrid.
Yeah.
Anyway, we'll get technical. I was talking pets there for a minute. I got a little pet petty there, but it's his dog.
It's snake guy. So.
Yeah. That's okay. There ain't much I haven't had. You see this right there? The reptile zoo? That's because I like everything.
Oh my gosh, look at this, guys. Oh wow. So this is Ty, some original, his first enclosures that he built. Even though they're, to some of you, you might think they're beautiful and better looking some of the other enclosures, but here's the funny part. These are his first ones and now he's upgraded them. And so what you see is not necessarily what you think is the best. Sometimes is not exactly as good as some of the others. Type of things. A lot of people don't understand like that, especially with snakes. They see a smaller enclosure and they don't know that when I put my snakes in the big enclosure, they won't breathe, they won't eat, they're just nervous. And we don't want animals nervous. We want them to be so comfortable that they want to reproduce. So come look at this. This is incredible. Okay guys, I just want to know, do you think this is amazing or what? And to think people think like reptiles don't like love. What do you think he's standing up for like this? He doesn't normally stand up like this. This is not his normal posture. He would normally, a normal wild animal would take off running, want nothing to do with it. But this guy here, he just wants love. Love and a little bit of stroking. He doesn't even stand up like this until you pet him. And anyway, I thought I'd give you something really cool to tag your friends in. And wow, living prehistoric pet.
Good job, right. Building cages, okay? So these guys are so big, there isn't any hawk that
no
can get them.
Oh,
yeah, okay, yeah. So I decided, okay, I'm just gonna build them like this, without any top, they get more sun, they get that, it just, and it works.
But yet this still keeps all the supports and
yeah. Strength. Right. So this is the third way for me to build them. This is the last iteration.
Right.
You know, you could, this is my philosophy. You know, I want to donate a lot of money to conservation.
Right, and if okay, you spend it all doing silly stuff, you can't do that.
I don't want to spend it all on building cages. And
right.
That costs a lot of money.
Right.
Okay, I can't cut corners on employees.
Right.
I can't cut corners on feeding them.
Right.
Okay? But one thing that I can cut corners is building these pens.
Right.
Okay? I'm not a zoo.
Because it has no effect whatsoever
exactly.
on the animal's welfare, because
exactly.
the welfare of the animal is determined by its environment,
mm-hmm.
and so this is just a simple way to make it where it can't escape without putting a bunch of money in it. It doesn't have to put some whole bunch of money over the top, and you don't yep. want to cover the top because you want the natural UV unfiltered sun. There's so everything's designed but for use, not for just to feel good and look at it. It's actually to do good.
So you want to come in and take a look at this.
So look at how beautiful, I mean, look at the animals. I mean, oh my goodness. The epitome of health.
This is 10 feet by 30 feet, right?
10 by 30.
All right, so I have a heated house that gets heated when it becomes less than 50 degrees at night. And then we have palm trees and water on top and a couple of lay areas where they could lay eggs. Very simple and functional.
Absolutely. They say function follows form, isn't it? Or form follows function. I don't know that old thing. All you artists out there are probably correcting me right now, but make sure you comment and put the right one. Okay, if you're not impressed yet, come on over here. Let me show you some really cool. Tell me these aren't absolutely gorgeous. Look at that. Albino iguanas. They're just absolutely beautiful. Look at the color on this. Oh, let's see. Look at the color. Just amazing. Come here. Look at that. Is that beautiful or is that ridiculously beautiful? Albino iguanas are just so impressive. And Ty's actually got some albino iguanas, but they're spiny-tailed iguanas. The only ones in the world. There's three in existence, and we're gonna show you one in just a minute. I just had to stop and take a minute and show you the albino iguanas. So nice. Beautiful, great disposition. We'll let him go back to his job over here of being the tough guy in the group. We interrupt this albino for a banana. Look at that, is that cool? She's a 7-year-old captive born banana iguana. It's a spiny tail and it's just so beautiful. Come from Mexico. Actually, where's the exact location of these?
Nobody knows.
Ah, I'm glad I don't feel like I didn't know, but it doesn't matter. I don't care if I know or not, I want to learn. How about you guys, you want to learn?
keep watching our station. Yeah, click that bell down there too, by the way. Otherwise, you're gonna miss out on all kinds of cool stuff. You might even miss out on Iguana Fest because it'll be too late because you didn't subscribe to us. So anyway, this is absolutely gorgeous. It's winter, so the color's not as bright as it normally would be, but boy, oh boy, there's no question how that got its name, right? Let's go look at the albinos.
Okay, this is Tinosaurus bakeri.
Bakeri, is this, I've never seen one. Absolutely gorgeous. Look at the, I mean, it's like turquoise as turquoise gets. I mean, wow, absolutely gorgeous. Man, I wish you could just catch those out loose in Florida, because it's, woo, it's beautiful.
This is the rarest spiny tail in the world.
The rarest spiny tail in the world. They're so rare, it's incredible.
Yeah, they're only found in a couple of miles in one island.
So how is that for contrast, you guys? How's that for contrast? I mean, is that beautiful or what? Look at the coloration difference between these two. Just gorgeous. Oh boy, guys. Woo, how'd you like to catch one of these out running around? This is actually the rarest spiny tail in the world because there's only three in the world. It's an albino, but then again, we talk about rareness, we're talking about the color and the beauty. And of course, some of you might say, ooh, it has no color, it's just all yellow. I think it's awesome. Of course, you know, if you're following us, that I'm into morphs, I'm into like different colors, I'm into the oddities. You know what? You're one of a kind, I'm one of a kind, so why don't I like one of a kind animals? Because we're all originals, and this is just a little bit different angle of an original. It's an original, even though all the animals are originals, I can't always tell them apart, but you can sure tell when they got a different pattern, different color and all that. So anyway, it's absolutely gorgeous. There's only three of these on Earth, and Ty owns them, all three of them. And hopefully he can change that mathematics soon. And who knows, maybe one day you can have one, or even me. So just thought I'd share it with you guys. Okay, you guys, getting ready to leave this awesome place, all kinds of cool stuff. Man, oh man, you better had a good time. I didn't even get it all because I have to go somewhere else. But by the way, don't forget the name. It's Ty's Park.
Oh,
see,
boy.
He's laying out in the park.
I'm a snake.
So this, he came up with a good name because really, honestly, this is a park to him. This is the awesomest wildlife park in the world to Ty. Am I wrong?
You bet. This is my so passion.
You have to make sure you make Iguana Fest, and if you don't, and it's already gone, and Iguana Fest is gone, you better go down and click that bell down there so the next cool thing that happens, you maybe can actually show up and be part of it. Because we want more people to be together than anything else. So take care, guys, and we'll see you soon.